know how to wear. The state is trying to we'll bring you into. You will feel all his power. The white cavalry will make contest the will of panties there. In the back of your head, yeah, you feel the flood again. Unleashing his hell, you will not even hear the bell. Maybe you're strong, but you don't stand a chance. Feel the power of a warrior. Fight.
HCWA fans, the voice of HCWA here, Matt Mahoney. And I tell you what, fans, what a brand new exciting show we have for you tonight, Wrestle Chat with HCWA. And man, this show is gonna be packed full of action. And I tell you what, I wanna talk to you about this weekend at the Wentworth Armory in Wentworth, North Carolina, the John Chilt Memorial Show is scheduled to go on at 7 o'clock. The doors open, 7:30 p.m. the show starts. But if the weather holds up, fans, you can check our Facebook for updates. We're gonna have them live on Facebook every day. We're gonna update it and update it to let you know. And like I said, this is a brand new show for HCWA fans. Anything is liable to happen. You know us, we are controversial. And I wanna bring in my first guest right now at this time, Jonni Roxville. Jonni Roxville, the man who's going to face the real deal, Lamont Steele, this weekend for the heavyweight championship of the HCWA. Mr. Roxville, how you feeling tonight?
Feeling great, baby, feeling great.
I tell you, live TV, Mr. Rockwell, we're finally on live TV.
Hey, that's fine. I'm always live. Mike Chex is always live. We're waiting. Saturday night is finally here. You know, I've been waiting a long time. I think a little bit later on, we're gonna show the contract sign. Definitely. Lamont smacked me around a little bit. But you know what? It's finally here. We're like four nights away. I've been training, I've been running. One day I ran. But that's all I need, baby. I'm ready to go. Bring it on Saturday night, 7 o'clock. Get your tickets. Be there and watch me either win that title or die trying.
And I tell you, fans, if he says he's going to do it, it's liable to happen. This man, there's no telling with the resident rock star, Jonni Roxville. And like I said, fans, we have DVDs that we're going to give away tonight. Trivia questions near the end of the show. Jonni Roxville has some tickets that he's going to give away for this weekend's show at the John Chilt Memorial Show. And like I said, there is no telling what's going to happen on this brand new show, HCWA Wrestle Chat. And call us, talk to us about anything. Let's talk about wrestling, what's going on in the entertainment world, as they want to call it. But we still call it HCWA professional wrestling. Isn't that right, Jonni?
Yeah, well, I call it wrestling. I don't know what this Wrestle Chat is.
it's
W.
No. Wrestle Chat. That's down south we call it Wrestle Chat.
All right.
And that's the new show.
See, I'm from LA, so I don't know anything about wrestle, but I'll play along with you.
Mm-hmm. You can't do anything with rock stars. And I don't want to leave out Mike Chex. You know, we got Mike Chex as Jonni Roxville's roadie, partner, sidekick.
My tour manager. Baby.
Main squeeze, whatever you want to. His
what?
Tour manager.
Hey, watch your head.
What? His main squeeze.
Main squeze, what are you talking about? I'm gonna main squeeze your head.
I
was on cue, baby.
Yeah,
baby. Yeah, on cue. See, and you never really know with these guys, fans. Twin brothers, different mothers. And again, you know, everything that's been going on in the HCWA right now, Jonni, let's talk about what happened between the feud between you and the outlaw Wayne Taylor. I mean, obviously, you dropped the title to him, it was controversial, you know?
The man stole my belt. All right, let's go back a couple months, okay? We had a bull rope match. I never been in a bull rope match. Like I said, I'm from LA. I don't know anything about a bull rope.
Yeah, cool.
Supposedly, the guy's never lost one. I whooped this dude so bad his legs quit working. He was caught up in the corner. He couldn't move, couldn't walk. I'm trying to bring him out. Jesse Santana brought out that briefcase he always carrying around. And you know what's in that briefcase?
Yeah.
I told you Because that dude's broke, man. I told you he's broke just for men's and D-pens is all he spends his money on. His hair is black as that camera right there. And he wears men's diapers. I'm going to say it right here live on television. The man wears diapers.
And I tell you what, man.
Anyway,
off. No, I'm sorry. This man is just too much sometimes.
You just shut up for a minute before you start laughing and ruin the whole show. Jesse Santana came in and hit me with a briefcase, right? I fall down, fat old nasty Wayne Taylor pins me, steals my belt. Next time we show up, I get my rematch. I'm in the ring, 5 minutes, maybe tops five and a half minutes.
Yeah,
I'm pounding this dude. I mean, I'm beating the ugly off of him, and that's hard to do, because that man is ugly. I tell you what, I ain't never seen a dude as ugly as Wayne Taylor. Have you ever, you know what I'm talking about?
Yeah, well, I think we've actually covered that in the
Well, we're going to cover it again, because some of these people here, they haven't seen what I said about Wayne Taylor. The man's got brown teeth. You know you're already starting off a bad day when your teeth is brown as Chucky Brown or whatever you want to say. He's got this big old growth on the back of his neck. I think he's got an alien crawling out of his head. I don't know what's going on with that. He stitches it up. He puts Band-Aids over it. Still can't hide it. The man stinks like cheddar cheese and goat poop. Every time he comes to the ring, I got to hold my breath first 3 minutes of the match so I don't puke on myself. I beat the man. Lamont still comes out. The guy spears me, about cuts me in half. And then it was on from there, see? The man kept my, Wayne Taylor took off with my belt. And then me and Lamont started going at it, and it's kind of evolved, you know. Yeah. I got a shot at him. Man said I couldn't get a shot at the belt unless I beat him in a...
Well, you definitely summed it up.
Well, I'm still summing. Well, don't cut me off.
I'm not, but just summing it up.
You cut me off again, I'm going to punch you through that wall over there.
Hey,
and then
I thought,
Mike Check
we're
is
cool,
going to come
man.
On.
We're cool.
Look, don't... I'm gonna, I ain't going to say it, but one more time.
Go ahead.
If you cut me off again, I'm going to take that telephone, and I'm going to stick it right up your bookie hole right here on live television. Anyway, as I was saying, man, I look good on TV. Check me out, Mike. Here, just pose for the camera. Give him one. Give him one right there. Anyway, like I was saying, I beat the man, non-title match. I got my title shot. We had the contract signing. The dude jumped me, brought out all his goons. He said he's going to do it by himself. He came to the ring, had JB Smooth in that goofy hat he wears. Who else was out there?
It don't matter.
Well, you know, who was
Josh
it?
Josh Starr, I think.
Who?
Mid-Atlantic Superstar.
Who's that? I said, sorry, Josh, I'm just kidding.
Yeah.
I know who you are last week when someone told me. But anyway, he was out there, Vice, that fat banana sandwich-eating Elvis-looking guy.
Yeah.
Who else? Taylor was out there, was stinking up the ring. And had one more out there, I can't remember who it was.
Not sure.
Help me out, Mike, come on.
Anytime you fans would like to call
Mike,
in,
I'm down
talk to Mr. Roxville.
Throw me a bone here.
Robert Ash
was out there, maybe. I can't remember who it was. I mean, they beat me up. Lamont slammed me down. I lost my memory for about a week. I don't, you know, I can't remember who all out there. But anyway,
yeah.
Signed a contract. It's no DQ, no time limit, no countouts. I could go take him out in 311 and stomp him. I can take him out and where he got all them army trucks, throw him in that army truck. They can't count us out. They can't DQ me. I'm going to do everything I can. I'll take my boot off. I'll smack him upside the head. It's all legal.
Yeah, and I agree. I mean, coming up this weekend, anything is liable to happen. And right now we have a call. Going to go ahead and go to the call.
That's probably my lawyer.
Yeah, I hope not. Hello, fan. You are on the air with Matt Mahoney and Jonni Roxville and Mike Chex.
This is Mahoney?
Yeah, this is Mahoney.
Okay, this is Santana.
Oh.
Mr. D-Pins himself has called in. What are you, this is a treat.
How's it going, Mr. Santana?
How's that brother doing, baby?
I called to talk to you. I called to talk to Mr. Smooth and Mahoney.
Well, okay, well.
First of all, Mahoney, you be quiet. Let me talk to J.B. Smooth.
Well, J.B.'s not on here yet, Mr.
Yeah.
Santana. He's coming on after our first commercial break. He's not on here yet.
He's not on there yet?
Not yet.
Well,
fans,
I got
this is Jesse Santana.
You with what you've been saying about me.
Me?
And things about me.
How's that bladder?
On your DVDs and on the TV show. First of all, between you and Roxel, I don't take Geritol.
What?
And I don't use just for men.
You don't
want to
sit up out of Geritol. You sound like you need some. Damn.
Mr. Santana, I never... Those accusations are not for me.
Don't even go there, son.
Get Alzheimer's, baby.
You
ain't nobody said about Geritol.
I will see you at the show Saturday night.
I never said, and those accusations are just outlandish. I never said anything like that. And fans, if you don't...
Let me put you on the spot. I'll have my guys cut the DVD up and send it to you, and you can see it. You be quiet now. Roxel, you're going after Lamont for the title, right?
Yeah, I believe that's correct.
Yeah, I've been gone for like 2 or 3 months. I've had things
were you?
Going on.
I didn't notice.
And I've seen where, and I don't understand what's going on with JB and what's been happening, and I'm backing up Lamont all the way. Good luck to you, son, because you're going to need it.
Yeah, well, Mr. Santana, before you go, What's the tension in JB Smooth Enterprises right now? And have you talked to JB Smooth about what's going on between him and Lamont Steele? Is there tension there, or what's going on?
I've called JB probably a half a dozen times, and I sent him emails. I've had my secretary call him, and he ain't called me back. He responded to anything. So I don't know what's going on. I've gone away for a couple of months and had some things going on, trying to get some stuff lined up. And what happens, JB, is I don't know what's going on.
Yeah, well,
I mean, he's interfering, he's getting up in there, and he's messing up Lamont, and I really don't know what's going on. And when I get back in town Friday, I'm going to give him another call. If he don't want to talk to me, don't answer my calls, I'll talk to him Saturday night at the show.
Yeah, well, I understand that. I understand you've been in Hawaii, and that's what they've been telling us.
I took 3 weeks in Hawaii. I wasn't just in Hawaii. I've been a little bit everywhere. I spent some time in Europe and a couple other places. I had to get out of town for a while because just things are going crazy. And this weather y'all got around here and everything is just driving me up nuts. And I had to get out of town for a while.
Well, we do appreciate you calling. And fans, if you don't know who's on the phone right now, it is Jesse Santana, the money man of the HCWA, one of JB Smooth Enterprises' partners, I guess you would say. And a very powerful man in the HCWA at this time.
Yeah.
Anything else you'd like to say to Jonni Roxville, Mr. Santana?
Good luck to you, son, because you're going to need it. You better bring your backup with you.
All right.
You better have all the rockers and all the bikers with you.
And you heard it first from Jesse Santana.
Yeah, goodbye.
All right, Mr. Santana, you have a good night. We appreciate you calling.
Yeah, you have a good one, too.
All right, thank you.
See
you, fans. Bye.
And fans, I tell you, Jonni, he is just out there when it comes to Jesse Santana. As you can tell, these two do not get along whatsoever. And, you know, being beside Jonni Roxville, it's hard for no one to get along with you. You're a very nice guy.
Tell you.
Yes, nice guy. I mean, swell-rounded guy. Can't beat him.
Right.
Anyways, fans, coming up, we're going to show you the contract signing between Jonni Roxville, the resident rock star, and the real deal, Lamont Steele, the HCWA heavyweight champion, show you all the action that went down at New Year's Revenge. And if you missed it, you can definitely check it out. We got DVDs for sale at the John Chilton Memorial Show this weekend. If the weather holds up, again, if it does not, you can check our Facebook page and see exactly what's going on there. So anytime, check it. We'll throw updates throughout the week, and it'll all be on our Facebook page. And Jonni, I know you check out our Facebook page. It's rocking, right? Ain't
yeah.
that what you guys say, rocking?
It's rocking.
Rocking, see? I'm down rockin', with the rock
baby.
Stars. I'm down. Matt Mahoney's down.
No, you're
no,
not really.
No, not really.
I'm down. I'm
no,
down.
No.
They're lying. I'm down.
No.
Hey. Cool. Oh, we have another caller. Caller, you're on the air with Matt Mahoney and Jonni Roxville and Mike Chex from HCWA Wrestling.
Doing commentary with you, I really get tired of watching you on my TV.
Oh man, here we go. Fans, if you don't know exactly who's calling in, it is my broadcast partner, Tim Cole, who is really not a big fan of you, Mr. Roxville, or you, Mr. Chex, or anybody else that is actually good in the HCWA.
Wait a minute, whoa. You said good. I am a sold out devotee to JB Smooth Enterprises, sir.
Yeah, I'm sure you're on his payroll too, partner. And I'll tell you one thing. Why do you think they call me the voice of HCWA and it's not Tim Cole the voice of HCWA?
Well, I done told you, I didn't vote on that mess and I don't know who come up with that crap, but I'm telling you what, I'm going to boycott until I figure out who it was.
Who are you going to boycott? What is it, the Boston Tea Party? You can't boycott.
Boston Tea Party? You don't even know when the Boston Tea Party was, you clown. Anyway, I guess I'll see
something.
You
it doesn't matter.
I got to sit in that broadcast booth with you Saturday anyway, so anyway, I'm going to let you go, but I'm tired of looking at you, so I'm going to let you go.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, well, you probably didn't pay your phone bill. So have a good night, Tim Cole. And fans, that was Tim Cole, my broadcast partner. If you have not saw him, we did a promo for Wrestle Chat. You can check it out on YouTube. All you have to do is type in Wrestle Chat promo, and it's pretty hilarious if you haven't saw it yet. And please, fans, go ahead and give us a call. We got DVDs to give away. We got tickets. Jonni Roxville over here holding some tickets. And Jonni, I think you're going to be, where are you going to be at tonight, Jonni?
What do you mean?
I mean, ain't you going somewhere after the show?
Be wherever I want to be, but I'll tell you what we got planned.
Yeah, I knew you had
me
something.
Me and Mike Chex, see, we're big fans of Mexican food, Hispanic food.
Hurts my stomach.
Spanish food, whatever you want to call it. So we're thinking about after this TV show goes off the air, we're going to roll down to El Parral here in Collinsville, Martinsville, wherever it is, right down the street.
Collinsville.
That's fine. We got tickets. We're going to hand out some tickets. We might sign some autographs. We might post some pictures.
Can I come?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I don't know.
What is that?
Cramp our style, man.
Cramp your style? I can be your wingman.
Look at that tie.
What? Oh, my God.
Chase all the women off.
I think I look nice.
Who they got that tie at Walmart? What are you talking about?
Whatever. This is not a faded glory tie. It's expensive tie. My dad bought me. He's a lawyer. He bought me this tie. Talking about my tie.
All right, well.
Anyways, fans, I tell you what. What an exciting show it's been so far. I hope you've enjoyed it. Wrestle Chat is going to be once a month now. Hopefully we can get it sooner. And, man, there's going to be nonstop action, if I'm allowed to say that, on this show. And we'll be right back right after this break.
Unexpected financial problems have happened to all of us. Reestablish your credit today. Bring in your tax refund check, and Nick Bellow, the credit master at Danville Toyota, will get you on the right track. He has helped thousands of people just like you to reestablish their credit from slow pay, layoff, divorce, bankruptcy, and even repossession. Use your tax refund and Nick Bellow will help you drive home a new or pre-owned car, truck, or SUV of your choice. Call this number or go to DanvilleToyota.com and click Second Chance Credit for a clean start.
At Southern Virginia Properties, you will receive friendly, reliable service for all your real estate needs.
Southern Virginia Properties helped us find our house. I'd encourage anyone who is serious about finding and buying a house in this market to contact Southern Virginia Properties.
I give all the credit in the world to Southern Virginia Properties. They really are dedicated to the work that they do, and they're dedicated to the community that they serve.
Thank you.
You're watching BTW 21, your neighborhood network, the pride of Martinsville.
Hi, I'm John Fry, Rocky Mount Family Pharmacy. We'd like to invite you to come see Family Pharmacy and give us a try today. We offer $4 and $10 prescriptions. We offer the $4 and $10 list, as well as immunizations, over-the-counter medications, diabetic care and supplies, candy flavorings. We have 50-cent greeting cards, low-priced makeup, sunglasses, reading glasses, and more. We offer free delivery within about a 10-mile radius. Give us a call at 489-5400. Let us be your family pharmacy today.
There are many reasons to choose Monroe Muffler Brake and Service for all of your car's maintenance, repair, and tire needs. We work on your schedule with convenient evening, Saturday, and even Sunday hours. We've earned our customers' trust with over 50 years of guaranteed quality service. And one more popular reason is Monroe's oil change and more for only $19.99. Plus, we'll rotate your tires, check tire pressure, and inspect your brakes for free. Trust Monroe to keep your car and your family safe. For dealer quality service for less, it's Monroe Muffler Brake and Service.
Riverside Furniture. Find great deals on Lazy Boy, name brand mattresses, and more. Pure Latex Bliss in all sizes with a 20-year warranty. Pure Bliss. Pillows starting at $49.95. Strongman mattresses starting at just $3.99. Layaway available on most items. Riverside Furniture. In business for over 50 years. Located at 1580 Greensboro Road. Riverside Furniture, your Lazy Boy soup.
The Southern Virginia Artisan Center, a program of Patrick Henry Community College located at 54 West Church Street in historic Uptown Martinsville, offers a wide variety of craft, design, and culinary classes. The Southern Virginia Artisan Center is home to the area's largest artisan and crafters retail gallery, which offers handcrafted work from over 80 local and regional artisans. Stop by or visit our website at www.southernvirginiaartisancenter.org for more details about our upcoming classes and gallery sales.
HCWA fans, welcome back to Wrestle Chat with Matt Mahoney. And right now, I want to take you straight to the contract signing between the resident rock star Jonni Roxville and the real deal Lamont Steele that happened at New Year's Revenge. Let's go ahead and roll that clip right now.
Oh,
to get this underway, I turn over to the master of ceremonies, the esteemed JB Smooth. Let's hear it!
Hey, my boyfriend's going to go back there in the back.
Shut up, girl.
Shut up. good close-up of that. That's what's going to happen to him next month. Him and anybody else that wants a piece of this.
HCWA fans, wow. We just saw the contract signing between the resident rock star and the real deal, Lamont Steel. That match is going to take place this weekend at the John Tilton Memorial Show in the Wentworth Armory in Wentworth, North Carolina. 7 o'clock, the doors open, 7:30 p.m. if the weather holds up. If not, check our Facebook. We'll throw updates, like I said before. And if the show gets canceled, we'll throw updates and tell you exactly when it's going to be. At this time, I want to bring on my other guest, which, again, I still have the resident rock star with me in my checks. But at this time, my pleasure, the boss, JB Smooth. Mr. Smooth, how are we doing tonight?
Hey, JB. Please.
Always.
Check. One, two.
Okay, it's fine.
All right.
Yeah.
I want to make sure it's fine.
I think it's okay.
It's fine. Can you hear me? Yes, yeah. It's fine. Oh, and I'm feeling fine, by the way, Matt Mahoney, and thank you for inviting me as a guest to my own show. That's great. You know I own this thing, right?
Yeah.
You know I own this? No, don't talk.
Yeah.
You've been talking.
Yeah.
It's time for me to talk now.
Okay.
Oh, hey, Jonni. It's good to see you. I'm glad they let you out of rehab for a few minutes.
You're funny.
Oh, Mike Checks, I'm glad you decided to dress up for this special occasion.
Hey, no
you're looking real dapper there, Mike Checks.
Only for you, brother.
Wow.
I smell cheap liquor and STDs. Do you smell that?
No.
Do you smell that, Mahoney?
What happened? You didn't take a bath before you
came
out
here? I know it's not me. I'm smooth and fresh and clean. I know that.
Yeah.
Wow.
But there's an amazing odor in here.
Real fresh.
Now.
He got that suit from his dead grandpa. Stole it right out of his coffin so he could wear it here tonight.
I tell you, man.
I don't know where you got that hat.
That's pretty low, Jonni.
Yeah, that's pretty low.
I mean,
guys,
that's low.
Can I say something for a second, boss?
Truth hurts.
I don't know. Can you?
I don't know. Can
Have you asked permission again?
May I say something right now, boss?
See, yes, you may. Say something right now.
Okay.
Say it right now.
I'm saying it right
say
now.
Say it.
Okay. HCWA fans, as I told you before, really, there's no telling what's going to happen on Wrestle Chat with HCWA. When you put these characters together with the voice, Matt Mahoney of the HCWA, there's no telling.
Okay, I would like to address that. The voice?
The voice.
The voice?
The voice.
You're going to have to put some more bass in that voice to be the voice of HCWA.
I'm
the voice, I'm the face, I'm the whole body. Never forget that.
Okay.
I run this thing in HCWA. The reason we're here today is because of me. And my man Jesse Santana, I'll give you a call. Sorry about that.
Yeah.
You know, I'm a very busy man. Jesse Santana, I'll be calling you very soon for strategy and all kinds of things like that.
He called you earlier, but you wasn't up here yet.
Yes, you know.
Go ahead and call him.
Apparently on my own show, I get booked second fiddle to,
call him up right
to
now.
A rock star over here.
Call him up. I bet you don't even have his number.
Well, fans.
Call him.
I'm sure he doesn't have his number. Fans,
call
check
up.
It out. We need someone to call us. 647-9289. Call us. Talk to Jonni Roxville, the resident rock star. Talk to Mike Chex. Talk to the boss, JB Smooth.
You're going to get yours this weekend, Roxville.
Matt Mahoney, the voice of HCWA.
Nobody
talk
wants
about.
A- Who wants,
wants
to talk to
me.
Matt Mahoney?
Someone
Who?
Wants to talk to me.
Please.
There's someone
Find me
there.
Somebody right here on the phone.
If you
Who
call
wants to talk to Matt
talk
Mahoney?
To me, you get a free DVD. How about that?
Oh, now you're bribing people.
Yes, I am.
Very nice. Okay.
Yeah.
If somebody wants a bribe to please call in and talk to Matt Mahoney, he'll give you a DVD of our show.
Free DVD. Actually.
Which are excellent, by the way.
They're excellent. We have a Thanksgiving Throwdown and Halloween Hellraising 3. And Jonni Roxville's kind of watching himself behind us here, so I don't think he's into it right now.
Hey, look, man, I'm on television.
Yeah, well, you're on television right here,
I'm watching my match, dude. Come on.
So, guys, let's get back to what's
going on. Pay attention to what's going on.
Well, put on a match that I don't want to watch, like, you know,
I know
some
you're probably
of
sky high right now, but please try to focus
on
the task at hand.
Let's get back to what's going on right now. This weekend, there's going to be a match.
Wait, hold on a second.
Okay.
What's this sky-high business?
Oh, here we go.
Are you trying to insinuate something? Look, I don't do any drugs. Only thing I do is I drink Rockstar energy drinks. You guys owe me some money for this. You look right on the side. Hold on, you shut up right now a minute.
I don't think you can do that.
Rockstar Energy Drink is designed for those who lead active lifestyles, from athletes to rock stars. I'm a little bit of both.
I think that's
you're a whole lot of neither.
Shameless
so
plug
shut
now?
Your mouth.
I think that's infringement.
Is it infringement? How is it infringement?
It might be. I ain't saying
I made the stuff. I'm just saying I drink it.
I called my dad. I'm not sure. He's a lawyer. I don't know.
If I'm infringing, I'm sorry. Don't sue me because I spent all my money on women and Hooters Hot Wings.
Well, let's get back to what's going on in the HCWA right now. First off.
Yes, please. Let's get
first off,
what
I want.
What is going on in HCWA?
Well,
right
what's
now?
Going on right now is this weekend, this man, the resident rock star, is going to go one-on-one with your JB Smooth Enterprises heavyweight champ, I guess you would say, or the HCWA heavyweight champ, the real deal, Lamont Steele.
Yes.
And what is your prediction of the outcome of that matchup? Because if Jonni wins, the whole shift of the HCWA may change.
Did you just ask me what my prediction for the match is?
I mean, yeah. Well, you have cost Lamont the last two matches. It is true, though. You've cost Lamont.
I'm watching my match, dude. Look at this. Look at that drop kick. What I'm going to do to him Saturday night, I'm going to drop kick that big old bowling ball head right at the back of the building.
So the boss can say something,
please. Oh, you're talking?
Yes, I am.
I did ask him a question.
He did just ask me a question.
Oh, I'm sorry.
I did ask him.
Which I forgot because you were running your yapper over there. Will you please repeat the question, Mahoney?
Well, I asked you the question, what is your prediction when the resident rock star meets the real deal Lamont Steele for the heavyweight championship?
Oh, yeah, that's right. And then I asked you a question. What do you think my prediction for that match is?
Well, and again,
my man, the real deal, Lamont Steele, is going to wipe the mat with Jonni Roxville.
The mat.
No doubt.
Well, you know, you have cost the real deal, Lamont Steele, two matches in the past 2 months. And it doesn't seem... Let's talk about what's going on. Why do you have to bring up old stuff? No, it's not
We're
old.
Here to talk
Hold on,
about
wait a minute. We have a call.
Saturday.
We have a call, JB. Hold on 1 second. You're live on the air. HCWA Wrestle Chat.
What's going on, man? You know who it is.
Oh, look. HCWA fans, it is a member of JB Smooth Enterprises, none other than Vice. Vice, what is going on? You are on the air, Matt Mahoney, JB Smooth, Jonni Roxville, Mike's Chex. What's going on, Vice?
You got Jonni Roxville down there. I'll tell you what, man, me and him go way back. You know, I remember when he was doing a Guns N' Roses tribute thing down at the skating rink, like Rifles and Daisies, I think they called it. Yeah, me and him go way back.
Yeah. Guns N' Roses.
You don't remember that.
Yeah, I do, baby.
That was a good time, bro.
Vice.
Yeah, man.
Really? Guns N' Roses?
We do. We pack that place out every Saturday night. I wish we were still doing that.
I know, man. We'll have to go back there.
We can do that part-time.
I'll tell you what, Vice, what we were talking about right now is what is going to happen when Jonni Roxville meets the real deal Lamont Steele this weekend for the HCWA Heavyweight Championship. What's going to happen? What's your prediction on that matchup?
You know what? I'll tell you what, man. You know, Roxville, I give him credit. He's a true rock star. You know what I'm saying?
I agree.
But when it comes to the Enterprises, we only run with the best. Roxville's going to have his hands full. Lamont's coming out on top. That's my prediction. I don't know.
All right, and another question while I got you on the phone.
Very good, Vice.
What's up?
That's why you're in the Enterprise, man. You got a good head on your shoulders.
And that's from the boss. What's next for the Smooth Criminals in the HCWA? Maybe the tag team titles? Are you guys going to win the tag team tournaments at the John Chill Memorial?
Man, of course. It's a lot. That's why we in the match. You know, everybody else is just there for show. We're there to steal the show. You understand?
Yeah, I understand that. Do you have anything you would like to say to the HCWA fans, or maybe Jonni Roxville, JB Smooth, Mike Chex, anything, Vice?
I tell you what, man. You just make it to the show. You make it to that armory on the 15th, and I'll do all the talking I need to do that night.
And I tell you what, fans, you heard it first from Vice, one of our outlandish characters, one of the best wrestlers that we have in the HCWA.
And future HCWA Tag Team Champion of the World.
And that's definitely a possibility. Him
and
Robert Ashe could definitely be the HCWA Tag Team Champions. Only time would tell. Vice, we appreciate you calling, brother.
Oh, yeah, man. You take it easy down there.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. You have a good one. And that was Vice. And I'm sure you're happy. You know, you got two members of JB Smooth Enterprises calling.
Don't tell me how I'm supposed to feel.
Are you going to smack me again? Don't do that.
I might.
No.
Go ahead.
And again,
I might put this somewhere you're not going to enjoy too much.
Don't worry.
A few weeks ago, this man smacked me in the ring for a job performance. We're not going to talk about that right now. Lawyers and fees, it's just under the wraps right now. But anyways.
No comment.
Yeah, no comment. Let's go back to exactly what more things are going on in the HCWA right now. You got your man, Outlaw Wayne Taylor, going one-on-one with Kid Lightning. Wait a minute. We have another call coming in. You're live on the air with HCWA Wrestle Chat.
Yeah, I got something to say. JB Smooth sucks.
Yeah.
Well, there you go. You got a fan right there, JB.
Who's back there screening Johnny these Roxville? Phone calls? Who's letting these morons call in?
You kick butt.
That's right. Who is this? Who are we talking to?
Who are we talking to, ma'am?
I tell you what, I'll kick your butt, JB Smooth.
Did you say Jonni Roxville licks butt? Is that what you said?
Oh, look.
I think you made the caller leave, JB. Thank you for calling in, ma'am. And if you'd like to call back, we have free DVDs that we're going to give out
for the trivia, and we have
free tickets that we're going to give out. Look, Jonni Roxville.
Let me tell you something.
Mic checks. I'm shutting up
this
now.
This guy just on live television just said I licked butt. Now, I'm going to fix it.
I didn't say that. Shut your mouth,
you goofy cracker. Look. I'm going to take this microphone off, and I'm going to go to your ass right here in a minute.
You touch me, and you're fired. I'm untouchable. You touch me, and you're fired.
I don't think you can say the A word on national television, boss.
I said Apple. Sorry.
Okay. I'm not sure you can say that. Fans, we do apologize if the lingers a little vaggle. Excuse me, vulgar, because I do have professional wrestlers. They're highly trained professionals, as you can tell. And things do get heated when we have bitter rivals.
Stop talking. I'm about to tell you the next question that you're going to ask me, the next topic that we're going to talk about.
Okay, yeah, go ahead.
Actually, you're not going to say anything. I'm just going to get into it.
All right, go ahead.
The match that I made between J.W. Dalton.
Oh.
Oh, yeah, you remember that?
That was going to be my next question.
My brilliant plan?
Yeah.
Versus the aging rebel, Robert Stanley.
Raging.
He's also aging, but believe me,
rapidly.
Anyway, in his triumphant return, I guess you could say, to HCWA, yes, he's been here the whole time, posing as a masked fool, the Redneck Rider. Yes, we all know Robert Stanley is the Redneck Rider. Yes. Stop saying things behind my back,
or to my side, or wherever you are. We have video proof. We have video proof.
You can Photoshop things. You could put another guy in a mask.
JB,
who knows?
He was in the ring with you at the same time.
Who knows?
Okay. Did I say anything else? Don't talk.
Shh. J.W. Dalton and the Raging Rebel. Robert Stanley will be in a hangman's jury match for the HCWA Anarchy Championship. For those of you who don't know, a hangman's jury match is just like, for those old school heads out there, is just like an old Indian match.
Or a strap match.
Strap match, Indian strap match. I can say what I want to say.
You gotta say Native American strap match. What's wrong
with
you?
Anyway, it is a match in where to gain victory, one competitor must put a leather strap around the opponent's wrist and drag them to each corner. In a hangman's jury match, let me tell you.
Yep.
I know what I'm talking about. Y'all shut up.
I'm sorry.
Shut up.
Shut up.
In a hangman's jury match, there will be a pole at one corner of the ring with a noose hanging from that pole. Would you listen? The boss is talking now. Listen.
I'm listening. How could I not hear you yelling and spitting and stinking?
He's not spitting. I'm sitting right beside him.
He's spitting.
He's not.
I saw some spittle land on the table right here. I need a napkin. Give me a wet nap up here.
I got a little bit on my sleeve right there.
I'll tell you what. Jonni Roxville needs a
May
wet
I
nap
please continue?
On Wrestle Chat. Go ahead. Continue. You're talking about...
In order to win this match, one man must incapacitate... That's a big word. You guys know what incapacitate means, right?
Yeah, we know it.
Must incapacitate his opponent enough to get that noose, put it around his neck, and then drag him from turnbuckle to turnbuckle and hit the top turnbuckle in succession. If the opponent stops his progress before he gets to that fourth turnbuckle, then he must begin again. And I know for a fact, these two men, even though they are redneck buddies, they're friends, whatever, lifelong buddies, I know that these two are gonna beat the ever-loving stuffing out of each other. That's why it doesn't even matter to me who wins the match. Because I know they're going to take each other out, that they're not going to be suitable for competition for the rest of the year.
Can I say something? Okay, my question is
wait,
you.
No, wait.
Okay, waiting.
Okay, now you can say something.
Okay. Is it not true that this Hangman Jury match is actually one of the first, if not the first match in professional wrestling ever as its kind? The first one.
I'm not sure exactly what you said just now, but this match will be the first of its kind in wrestling history. That is right. Because I'm JB. I got the brains. Oh. I come up with this stuff like this.
Okay. And that's exactly what I asked you. But are you really trying to build a wedge between the raging rebel, Robert Stanley?
Build a wedge?
And J.W. Dalton. Yes, you're trying to build a wedge. And Jonni Roxville's sleeping, so I think you're boring into that. I'm not sure.
Well, he's going to need all the rest he can get for Saturday when the real deal Lamont Steel kicks his butt.
Fans, we also want to remind you we have free DVDs if you'd like to call in.
I wasn't finished yet.
Sorry, I'm just trying to promote the show. Go ahead, do your thing.
Not only is it a Hangman's Jury match, but J.W. Dalton also decided to make a stipulation that the fans can bring their own weapons. And I have agreed to his stipulation. So fans out there, come February 15th, this Saturday, the John Chilt Memorial Show. Bring the kitchen sink. Bring a golf club. Bring a baseball bat. Bring some fishing line. I don't care what you bring.
Wrap it in barbed wire.
Bring a wig that looks like Jonni Roxville.
What?
Yeah, you wear a wig. Don't even lie.
I don't think that's a wig, man.
That's your real hair?
I don't think
so. I put Revlon in here.
Revlon.
A Prill.
You don't shop at Avon, do you? I don't think so.
I got some.
I don't think he shops at Avon.
Yeah.
Hey, I know a chick who sells for Avon.
Well, I do too, actually. You link up. I don't know.
I said Revlon, not Avon.
Whatever. I'm not sure. Prill. Anyways, fans.
It smells like the floor of a Vanagon.
Man, I can't. Anyways, fans, again, we have tickets for this weekend's John Chilt Memorial Show, the Wentworth Armory. Doors open 7 o'clock, bell time 7:30. If the weather holds up, definitely check our Facebook for updates on that.
We will let you know no later.
He's the boss.
Then Saturday at noon, whether the show is going down or not.
Saturday at noon.
But check. That will be the very latest. If we know we're not going to have the show Friday, then yes, Matt Mahoney, we'll let them know then.
Oh, yes, sir.
But we'll let them know by noon on Saturday at the latest what is happening with the show. If the show doesn't go down this weekend, I hope it does. So this
Me
man
too.
Can go down.
Me too.
If it doesn't happen, then we will shift the card to March.
What?
And the show will happen in March. That's the last resort. We're really hoping the show goes down because I want to see you go down at the hands of Lamont Steel.
Fans, I would definitely hate to see it go that way, but if the weather holds up, we're definitely going to have the show this weekend, February the 15th. The John Chilt Memorial Show. You will see the resident rock star Jonni Roxville go head to head with the real deal Lamont Steel for the HCWA Heavyweight Championship. There's no telling. Again, you'll see the Hangman's Jury match between the raging rebel Robert Stanley and J.W. Dalton, two best friends going for the Anarchy title. Man, what's going to happen? J.B. Smooth will be there with all his Goonies, Enterprises. Hey. Sorry about that.
Watch your mouth, Mahoney.
I'm sorry about that. And then Jonni Roxville, Mike Chex, the whole crew is going to be there. All the HCWA superstars, the AOD, Kid Lightning and his gang, everyone's going to be there. Hey, Ryan Grimes might even be there. You know who that is?
I can't believe you just name checks the Army of Dorkness, really. That great, yeah. Yeah, the Army of Dorkness will definitely be there, acting goofy the and dork? Acting dorkies. What? The Army of Dorkness.
Okay, well, fans, again, we have free DVDs. We have a few minutes left. Free DVDs for you. Free tickets. Jonni Roxville is going to be at El Parral tonight. Right after the show, come hang out with him. Chill, autographs, have a few, whatever you want to do. Jonni Roxville, El Parral. And I tell you what, this show's been exciting. I don't know, I'm getting hot up here. I mean, it's hot.
Whoa. What? Calm down, Mahoney.
It's getting hot.
Calm down.
We don't have much time left.
I know I'm a handsome man, but calm down over here, please.
We don't have much time left, but I tell you what, guys. JB, right, Jonni, is there anything you want to say to JB? JB, is there anything you want
to say? I don't have anything to say to JB. Something to show JB.
What is he doing?
How much time we got?
Don't you dare touch me.
We only got like 5 minutes. I'm a little confused.
Get out of the way.
I don't want to move.
Where are you going?
I'm not trying to move.
What do you got? What do you have to show me?
I don't want
to
move.
Don't touch me.
Don't touch me.
Do more than touch you.
Please don't touch me.
Hey, you're messing the setup.
Watch.
I'm gonna mess you up.
Hold on now. Don't move. Wait a minute. Wait, fans.
Look,
hold on now.
I want you.
There's no telling what's gonna happen on Wrestle Chat with HCWA.
I'm not gonna do anything. You just listen. Put that down. Sit this over here.
Confrontation.
Take this little stupid stick.
No, hey, you can't have my stick.
Give me the stick.
You can't have my stick.
You either give me this stick or I'm gonna take this stick.
I'm gonna fire you if you don't let go of my stick.
You
ain't
gonna
fire me.
Why are you gonna fire me? Look behind you.
I'll hold the stick.
Now I'll fire both of you. I'll fire you too.
You ain't gonna fire nothing.
I need my job, sir.
In fact, are you even employed here?
I'm employed here. Okay.
Now I want you to breathe the other way, please. You got dragon breath, baby. I'm just gonna be honest with you.
You smell like
Smirnoff. Just don't breathe for a minute. Just don't breathe for
venereal disease.
You listen to me and you listen good. I want you to pass this on to the one, because in 4 days, I'm going to take his belt. We're getting ready to go to El Parral. I'm going to tell you what, I'm even going to invite you. I'm going to invite you to come with us. I'll buy you dinner.
You're going to buy me dinner.
That's going to be my gift to you, because this Saturday night I'm taking something from JB Smooth Enterprises. But when we get to El Parral, you're going to have to sit down at the end of the table so I don't have to smell your dookie breath and look at those long 3-inch nasal hairs hanging out your nose while I'm trying to eat, making me
nasal sick. Hairs?
Look, we got tickets.
You talking to me about nasal hairs?
Yeah. See this right here? It's getting ready to meet your jaw. And you can fire me. All the fans, they'll ride in. I'll be back in 1 week. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, we do need him, kind of.
You know what I'm saying? So you can fire me all you want.
DVDs?
We got free DVDs. And we about, how much time we got? Because I'm getting ready to snap this joke right now.
Got about 2 minutes, Jonni. About 2 minutes.
Just got it on the air. 2 minutes.
I got 2 minutes to stand upright.
Get your stopwatch. Get your watch ready.
Watch is ready. 2 minutes.
I'm going to sit here and wait.
We got 2 minutes, fans, and I tell you what. What an episode. The very first episode of Wrestle Chat with Jonni Roxville.
This is my show.
JB Smooth, Mike Chex, the voice of HCWA, Matt Mahoney. What a show we've had tonight.
Don't tell me what to do, Jonni.
Don't forget about the John Chill Memorial Show this weekend, February the 15th. Jonni Roxville.
I run things around here.
Mahoney, this is getting out of hand. I don't know if I feel comfortable with the... All right, he's taking his jacket off. Can I get some security, please? I don't know.
Hold my head.
You've overstepped the line, Jonni.
Okay, now I have a hat on. I'm not sure.
This is my show.
I have a cane and a hat. I'm scared.
But before you get there... You're going to have to take a beating.
I don't have a hat on. I'm scared.
Come on over here. Get in front of this table.
Okay. I don't have a cane now.
Come on.
And now we got 2 minutes. We got like a minute and a half, guys. And fans, I just want to thank you for watching Wrestle Chat, the very first episode. As you can see, what's to come with Wrestle Chat in the future. There's no telling what's going to happen. Check our Facebook and our YouTube for the next guest on Wrestle Chat. And I'm getting pushed out the way. But I definitely can tell you, wait a minute, this is not good. And I can definitely tell you there are exciting things to come. I think JB just lost his hat.
Nobody knocks my head off.
Hey, wait a minute. I didn't do it. Lawyers.
You're going to pay, Jonni.
I have another hat on. I don't know what's going on. Johnny's on the phone.
911, come here, because JB Smooth's going to need a ride, baby.
Please, please. Oh, wait a minute. Johnny's chasing JB off the stage. I don't know what's going on. They're going out the front door. HCWA fans, this is Matt Mahoney. We want to say good fight and good night, and I don't know what's going on, fans. I'm stuck up here by myself. Oh, I got a hat on, no chairs. I'm not exactly sure what's going on. I'm stuck. The very first episode of Wrestle Chat, and I have no idea where my guests went.
Let's get through!